My name is Michael Moore, and this is the School of Public Policy. Today we released a paper on coking capacity, or the ability to process heavy oil in the Pacific Basin. When we say coking capacity, we mean oil that has very long chain molecules, very heavy and high in sulfur content. Here's why that matters for Alberta. Alberta has a surfeit of heavy oil that is difficult to get to those markets that have special refineries to deal with it. And we're trying to understand what the capability and the capacity of the Asia-Pacific market is to absorb future supplies of Canadian heavy oil. Well, currently there's what's been called a bitumen bubble that represents the discount that Canadian producers have to take to get to the wide world to be able to distribute or sell their product. That bubble represents the discount for distance and quality that we have to give up in order to price competitively against other world oils. If we can get access to markets like the Asia-Pacific market, then we're going to take less of a discount and we're going to be able to supply them competitively over a longer period of time. There's a current debate about pipeline routes throughout Canada, and assuming that we can resolve some of that debate or resolve some of the siting decisions, then getting access to those markets means that we can supply competitively a lot more of our Canadian products. The question about whether or not there's enough capacity in the Asian markets was addressed directly in our report. We conclude that there's sufficient capacity today to upgrade our type of oil up to the limits that are proposed in the pipelines under consideration today. And right now, we're concerned that if we don't get access to that market pretty soon, that we'll have to face increasing competition from other countries. Well, here's what that means for oil producers, especially in Western Canada, is that access point is critical, has to be part of the long-term plans. For the province and the government, it means that we have to take into account the ability of future pipelines to support any growth in production output. And long-term, for the federal government, it means that we need a consistent siting policy for pipelines generally and pipelines specifically to deal with oil and in the future natural gas and perhaps other derivative products. The inconsistent approach to siting as far as interprovincial relationships causes some dismay on the part of potential buyers in the Pacific Rim who are looking for consistency in supply, and predictable decisions as far as where that long-term supply is going to come from. So the disarray in terms of approaching the problem causes a perception of higher risk in the part of the marketplace, and it makes other oil or other products relatively more attractive than ours. Well, there's been some discussion about whether or not we ought to have a Canadian brand that would make our oil or our energy products more attractive to the wide world. And one way to get that brand is to assure the world that there's a consistent and uninterrupted supply in the future and that its quality, even at a discount, is consistent over time. So our way of approaching the market and attaching that Canadian brand is to assure them that we're real and that we will continue to be real into the future. I'm Michael Moore. This is the School of Public Policy, and thank you for watching us.